What's up, guys, and welcome back to another Real Madrid review. Mallorca 1, Real Madrid 0. I mean, absolutely poor. What can I say? What can Real Madrid fans say? Except for Ancelotti doesn't get the backing, doesn't get the signings he needs for a very, very relentless second half to the season. Now, before we get into the game, and there really isn't much to talk about except for the goal that Mallorca scored and a couple of chances here and there, but except for those, if I was to do a normal review talking about the chances, it would last 2 minutes long. So I kind of want to first make the video slightly longer and talk and try to get Real Madrid fans and their frustrations out, and I'm part of those. I'm quite frustrated with the board, the club, and things right now that are things that needs to be done, which aren't done, and I think those things that haven't been done costed us. You know, it's games like these where you go, surely we win, and then because you don't have that quality and you sort of underestimate your opponent, that you lose. And fair play to Mallorca, you know, they got themselves a huge 3 points against Real Madrid. I don't want to talk about what happened between Raiolo, Pablo Maffeo, Vini Jr., Carvajal. We have been speaking about that for a very long time. I'll give a briefly thought about that. Whoever asked Raiolo about Vini Jr., I don't know what you're thinking asking that guy a question. If Raiolo himself came out with that and said like Vinny isn't a role model and stuff, then I don't know what he's doing. But whoever, if it was an interview who asked Raiolo, what are your thoughts on Vinny Jr., that is the most dumb question I've heard, by the way. And if he himself speak out on it, it's a dumb thing to speak out on as well. I don't understand this. We have seen it, you know, this season, especially those racist abuse that Vinny has been getting, and people are trying to compare it to Lionel Messi being fouled back when he was at Barcelona. What is a defender's job? Is a defender's job to stop an attacking player or to racially abuse another attacking player? Let me know and then come back to this conversation. I'm not gonna go on about this. And then obviously you got Pablo Maffeo trying to stick his nose in. You got Carvajal who actually also stick his nose in. Just stay out of this, right? Raiolo can do what he want. Carvajal responded, and now Pablo Maffeo responded. And it doesn't help that we lost. It doesn't help Carvajal. It doesn't help Vinny. The fact that they responded, and now we have lost. It actually helps Raiolo. It helps Pablo Maffeo. They can go to sleep better. And look, we'll put that aside for now. I don't really want to get into it. I think, look, something like this is very, very, very huge. And we've been saying it for a couple of reviews now, but I can't be sat here, and I don't think Madrid fans could be sat there every single day saying, why is Vinny getting racially abused? We need to stop this. We can't keep talking about that every single time. Right, they need to do something about it. They aren't doing anything about it. Yes, we have to make it public, and we have to make sure, and we have to keep telling them that something has to be done. But speaking about this, finding an excuse for the fact that we lost the game isn't something that we should be doing, really. So we'll brush it aside. To a more serious matter, and that is backing your manager. And look at the January transfer window. We've been speaking about this since the last 2-3 reviews. Now, I'm not going to go into details on missing out on Cancelo again, or Vlahovic again, or whoever again. But we did talk about the other review, I don't know which review, trusting Benzema to 2024. Now, he wasn't in the team. I think it was just resting him. I don't think he's seriously injured. I think it's just, let's give him a bit of a rest. Obviously, I think he's a bit of a muscle injury, not a serious injury, but you know, I'm sure he would be. It's not a massively serious injury, right? Now, who is the backup to Benzema? First up. And Rodrigo is a very good player, but he isn't a number 9. We can see it. Now, he can do a job when he's asked to, but he isn't your out and up number 9. Your Benzema's. He isn't your Benzema's, your Harry Kane's, your Robert Lewandowski's, even your Ronaldo's, and these sort of players. Rodrigo isn't that. He's a winger. He could play false 9, but he isn't a proper number 9. So, he's not going to be the future. I almost feel bad for Asensio today on that missed penalty. But we'll talk about that later on as well. He isn't a number 9 either. I know he has that physicality, he has the build. But realistically, are we going to play Asensio through the middle? Not really. And who else? Mariano came on and nearly scored. I mean, that is the state that we are currently at. The fact that we are relying on Mariano. And again, I almost feel bad for him. I know I don't really rate him as a player. I don't think Madrid fans rate him as a player. But he's been thrown under the bus. You know, we've been trying to find an answer. And Mariano has been thrown in. And when we don't have a solution, we say Mariano is the problem. And I do agree that Mariano isn't a Real Madrid quality player. I don't think he's good enough for Real Madrid. I don't think he should even have signed for Real Madrid. I don't know what the club are doing. But I'm not going to be sat there blaming Mariano for everything. Because it's not his fault. You know, what can he do? What can he do? Nothing much, really. He doesn't play much. When he does play, he's unfit. And when he's unfit, he's unfit and doesn't have the sharpness, and we're just putting him up front. That was how depressing it was. Hazard is injured again, even though he doesn't play. I mean, Hazard, his cycle is injured, recovers, gets back into the team, gets selected, onto the bench, gets injured without playing, and then the cycle repeats. It's very sad as well. So tell me, except for Vinny as well, who already is a guaranteed player, on the left, and we could include Valverde off the right, but he isn't going to be your striker. So your striker, who is it going to be? Except for Benzema. Mariano, Rodrigo, Asensio, Hazard. None of those players either fit the system and fit the build of a number 9 or are good enough. So, look, we need another backup. We've been calling, we've been crying for a backup to Benzema. They decided not to go with it. They trust Benzema. You may be able to trust Benzema for his goals. Yes, we'll trust Benzema scoring. But can you trust Benzema for his fitness? No. So what are we going to do? What are we going to do? We have nothing going for. We have one damn shot on target. And that was the penalty we missed. In 98 minutes. Because of extra time. We have had one shot on target. One. And you're trying to tell me we don't need a backup striker to Karim Benzema. Honestly, I feel like the board right now is just trying to find ways to make Madrid fans pissed. Because honestly, I don't understand this, right? And I've been seeing news as well. The club might not go for another right back. They will focus on Jude Bellingham. What would Jude Bellingham bring you? Except for another midfielder. Does Jude Bellingham play striker? Can he play as a striker? Right now, we have Modric, okay? He's 38, okay? Cruz, I know he might retire. So you got two older players. But except for those two, you have four midfielders compared to one striker, right? Four midfielders compared to one striker. I know you usually play with one striker and three midfielders, but you still have more than enough midfielders, at least for the formation we play, than the striker, right? We have got Ceballos, who might extend based on how he has been playing for the last couple of weeks. You got Tchouaméni, Camavinga, Valverde. And then you might be able to get some younger players from Castilla. Arribas maybe. And look, we can definitely find a way. But do we have another striker? No. So, look. Something has to change. Something has to be done in the summer. We need to bring in backup to Benzema. Don't give me this. We'll rely on him till Endrick comes in. Because you're not only going to wait for Endrick to come in, you're going to wait for him to settle down. And by the time Endrick settles down, Benzema is probably going to be 37, 38. So please don't tell me you're going to rely on Benzema until he's 37, 38 when he can't even stay fit at 34, 35. Which I don't blame him for doing so. You know, it's got to do with your body and your health. And it's an age thing, right? When you grow older, the more injuries you start to have. So I can't blame Benzema for that. But we have to get another player in, get another body in. And it's just really, really, really disgraceful that we are not. And we haven't done so. Jovic failed. Mariano shouldn't even be at the club. I feel bad for him. I know he's earning, what, 200k a week or whatever he earns nowadays. But he gets undeserved hate for no reason. But I do agree that I myself have done it before. I have said and I have talked about him in terms of him not being a Real Madrid quality player. And he isn't a Real Madrid quality player. He isn't good enough for Real Madrid. He was killing it at Lyon, but that's probably his level. But I'm not going to start blaming him that we didn't beat, win or get a draw today. So, you know, it's what it is. Absolutely shocking. Anything else I wanted to add? I mean, that, we can go back to that Vini Jr. thing. I'll prefer not to talk about that, but look, the opponents can do whatever they want. You know, Vallejo, you know, he clearly wanted to have some. You know, throughout the whole game, I don't know if I was watching football or I was watching like boxing. I don't know what is happening. I don't know what he's trying to achieve out of this. You know, I mean, him and Vinny were just going at each other, and you know, it's what it is. I didn't really understood why Carvalho got involved on social media and said like, who is this Vallejo guy, I'll go talk to him. And then Maffeo gets involved as well after the match. So look, overall it's a mess. You know, the league has to do something about this, right? The players, the opponents can do whatever they want. You know, they want to take the piss, they want to do things like this. They can do what they want. Let's not get affected by them. Let's talk about more on the football. Right? If we play really, really well and that happened, yes, we could discuss more on that. But what is the main issue today wasn't the fact that Vallejo and Vini, you know, were going at each other, or Carvajal and Maffeo were going at each other, or what is happening with Vini, which I don't condemn it. I don't think anyone should. I don't think the Liga should. I don't think any players should. I don't know any people in the world should, really. But this isn't the main issue of the match. And the fact was, we had one shot on target for 98 minutes. So that's definitely more important things to talk about. Let's talk about the goal, shall we? The only goal scored by Mallorca. Rodriguez actually sent in a cross. And I think it was an own goal by Nacho. I looked at that replay for like 10 times. I have no idea how it isn't a goal to Morici and how it was a own goal. I think it might have hit his head and went in. Also, people saying, how did Lunin not get it? By the way, Lunin came in to replace Courtois quite late on. I think it's something to do with his left leg, left abductor, I think it was. On his left leg, so speedy recovery, Thibaut. We need him, he's a crucial player. Hopefully he's fine. But Lunin came in, and that goal, I've never seen anyone online today say it's Lunin's fault. And if I see anyone say that, I'll be thinking, are Real Madrid fans genuinely that depressed now that they're just trying to find a blame? They're trying to find someone, a scapegoat. Honestly, I have no idea how you expect a goalkeeper to save that. That ball literally just heads it over him, basically. Even if he had reacted earlier, he wouldn't have managed to save it. I'll name me some of the best goalkeepers in the world and tell me who can save it. Can Neuer save it? Can De Gea save it? Can Jan Oblak save it? Maybe they can. On their best, I think Prime Neuer, he could save everything. I think Prime De Gea, he could save everything. Maybe Prime Oblak, maybe Prime Courtois, maybe Prime Buffon. You know? But Lulin is just a young goalkeeper who hasn't played much. The last time he played was October, I believe. I remember the last time I seen him play was like Elche. So that was a few months ago. And since then, Courtois has come back in. Lulin has been a backup. And it's a late call. It was literally during the warm-ups, the pre-match warm-ups, where Lulin just felt a discomfort and Lulin had to come on. So he had probably 25 minutes to warm up as well and to get ready. So look, don't expect much from Lulin. You can't blame a goalkeeper for that. Especially not a young goalkeeper who had to come in last minute. Apart from that, we had tons of shots. Just none of them were target. Valverde had a shot in the 41st minute, way over the bar. We had a penalty, like I said. Vinicius Junior clipped down by Rajkovic. Penalty awarded. No idea why Asensio was the penalty kick taker. Ancelotti said that I decided, not me, but he decided to let Asensio take it over Rodrigo after Rodrigo missed a penalty for Brazil against Croatia and it could have affected him. I can understand that you know it might affect him, but I think he has to move past it, right? Ancelotti, he can't. Let's say we have a penalty in 2 years' time, and the player who should be taking it is Rodrigo. The future manager, whether it's Ancelotti or another manager, can't be saying, "Oh, 3 years ago or 2.5 years ago, Rodrigo stepped up against against Croatia for Brazil and he missed, so I'm gonna give it to another player." You can't be doing that. It's been 2 months since that happened. Rodrigo has probably moved past it. Rodrigo should have stepped up and he would have scored, in my opinion. Look at the Asensio run up to the penalty. It was so obvious he was gonna go there. It's so obvious. The fact that he couldn't just run up and slam it home. He ran, slowed down, stared at the goalkeeper for like 10 seconds, and then shoot. I mean, come on. Come on. The goalkeeper was always gonna get it. He was looking at Asensio and he was going, "I bet he's going to my left and he's right." For sure, look at the way he's stepping up, look at the way he's slowed down, look at where he's looking at. It's very, very obvious. And Rodrigo should have taken it. Asensio should not have taken it. But again, we move, it's our own fault, we can't blame anyone for that. And then 66 minutes in, Asensio had a low driven attempt wide. Mallorca had a chance, Antonio Sanchez with a shot straight into the arms of Lunin. Two chances for Mariano here. The first one from Alaba's cross, volley over, could have scored probably. And Modric cross headed over by Mariano here as well. And the last chance of the game, 98 minutes in. Cruz with a cross in, and Rudiger heads it just right. So realistically, nothing going for us. And we totally deserved the result because of the performance we showed. We didn't play well. And one more thing I'll talk about here is, are we out of the title race? Now, I'm pretty sure it's still 5 points, but Barcelona are yet to play, and they're playing Sevilla next. Now, I don't know when this video is gonna go live, when this video is gonna go out, but when I'm recording, the game has just finished. So, look, I anticipate and I expect Barcelona to beat Sevilla to win. So that means they'll go 8 points clear. Now 8 points is either could be 3 losses for Barcelona while we win 3 games, or 2 losses and 2 draws, and then we will probably still have to get better goal difference. So maybe 2 losses, 3 draws. So realistically, we're looking at Barca losing 3 of their next. I don't know how many games there are left, but 3 of their next, you know, FILA Liga games, right? To the end of the season, 3 games we are expecting and hoping that Barcelona lose until the end of the season. I don't think that's gonna happen. I genuinely don't think that will happen. Maybe we can hope for Barcelona to draw, but three games seems a lot, considering we can drop more points. If we drop more points, it'll be even harder to catch up. If whether we are out of the race, I don't think we're out of the race. I think Real Madrid will never be out of the race, unless it's maybe 10 or 15 points, right? I will only start losing hope when we are 10 points behind, right? The next time we are playing, I think, is in the league, it's against Osasuna. If we draw or lose that game and Barca win their next game after Sevilla in the Liga, I will put my hands down and say, look, I think Barcelona will win it. And now the rookies will have it as Barcelona favourites, which is understandable, right? No questions. They're 8 points clear. They will be favourites to win it, and they are favourites to win it, right? But let it be. The pressure is now on Barcelona to perform, right? Those players under Xavi and Barcelona know that the pressure is on them, not on us. Now, technically, it is on us because we are trying to catch them up. But will they slip up? Will they drop some points to some teams in the league? Who knows? But the pressure is on them to keep this momentum, to keep this run of form up, which I think eventually they'll run out of steam, like most teams, and I think every team in the top leagues at least, playing 2 to 3 games per week. You know, I think you'll eventually run out of steam, and fatigue and tiredness will come into play, and God knows when that will happen for Barca. They aren't playing too many games yet, but the Europa League will be back. Obviously, we've got Copa del Rey, we got, you know, multiple trophies and competitions as well. So I'm hoping that Barca slip up, but we'll see. But again, don't rule Real Madrid out just yet. I think we are still in it. I will only put my hands down and say I think Barca will win it if we drop more points and Barca gain more points on us. So we'll see. And that isn't being stubborn, but Real Madrid fans, or just any fans, you wouldn't want to put your team down and say we've lost it, we're not going to win it, our rivals are going to win it. No one would want to do that. And it's the same here. I don't really want to say Barca have won it, right? I don't really want to say it. So look, for me right now, the main focus is on the next games. We've got the Club World Cup coming up. We've got Champions League against Liverpool coming up. I mean, for God's sake, I mean, we are playing such poorly and so are Liverpool. But I really anticipate, and I won't be surprised if Liverpool come to the Bernabeu and smash us. I mean, the Premier League, they have been doing quite poorly. They're 11th, I believe, which is incredibly surprising, shocking for Liverpool. But I think the Champions League is a different competition. I think now they have their hopes on the Champions League, hoping that that will be a way for them to get some trophies and to win some tournament potentially, because I don't think they will get top 4 now. So that'll be an interesting game to watch, you know. And yeah, we've got now the Club World Cup, we've got the Copa del Rey, we've got the Champions League, we've got La Liga, we got 4 trophies in at least the next month or so. And if you go further down the Champions League, if you go into the final of the Super Cup, not Super Cup, but the Copa de España, the La Liga will still have more games. Obviously, the Club World Cup will only be a couple of days / a week / weeks potentially. So look, we've got more games coming up. This will be a very tough season. Hopefully we can win some games now, but fair play to Mallorca. They fully deserve it. And on the Vini Jr. thing, look, Raiolo, Maffeo can do what they want. They can take the piss. It doesn't bother me. And I don't think it should bother the players, you know? I don't think Vini should get bothered. I don't think Carvajal should get bothered. So we just have to move on to our next game in the Club World Cup. Who are actually our opponents? I haven't checked just yet. Our next opponents are Ali, I think, are their name. I'm sorry if I've screwed their name up. Semi-finals. Can we beat them? I hope we can. But that will be it for today's review. Hope you guys have enjoyed today's review. Hit the like button where I stayed. Subscribe to the channel if it's on already. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.